this is Victor. I'm here with the fourth part on the painting tutorial of the Celestant Prime. And this time I want to explain how I'm going to paint the armor. I will share with you how I will paint the armor. And if you have followed my channel, you know that normally I paint my Stonecast Eternals in green colors. But in that case, I will go for the gold, as we see. We can find in the painting from my workshop. The reason why I prefer to go for gold on that guy is because I want him to be different from the rest. He is the prime hero of Sigmar. He's the avatar of Sigmar. So I want him to, I think he can deviate from the rest of the army. And on top, he's not really attached to any army. So I will paint the armor completely gold. And to use that, I will start with a layer of Retributor Armor, and I will use this the base color. As you can see, I will paint the parts, not glue it. And the reason is because I want to have accessibility to all the parts. Of course, then I will need to do some touches once I assemble everything together, in case I see the slots or the join between the parts. But at this moment, I will just apply a layer of Retributor Armor. This Retributor Armor is a great base if you want to paint gold. I really recommend this color. I'm very happy how this is working on top of white, on top of black. So doesn't matter what color you prime, the Retributor Armor is covering perfectly. And you will have a very even layer. So I will start applying as a base of Retributor Armor. And once this is done, I will come back. So, because here there is not much technique to explain, just as usual, make a thin layer, thin your paints down, avoid that the paint is accumulated in any of the places. As you can see, I'm leaving the belt in that case in white, because the belt I will paint it in leather colors or this type of belt. So, I will leave this white. Okay, but you can see here I paint this part. And now I still keep the leg not attached, not to glue it. I want to keep it separate for the moment. I will see if I will glue it later on, but at this moment I will keep it separated. Okay, and the idea is, as you can see, I will do these runes in glowing blue, as I have done for a lot of the runes in my army. I want him really to have this magical look. And you can enhance the magical look just by adding some glowing. So, but for the moment, I will apply a layer of gold. I will paint the full armor on gold. I will not care if these runes or not. I will go all over the place. And once this is done, I will be back. So I will keep doing that, and I will be back once this is done. So after doing the gold, we are going to use Doombull Brown to paint these joints of the armor. Okay. Especially on the leg. Right. I'm going to do here at the back of this leg. And here we also want to do just below the shoulders, the joint with the arms. Perfect. And do a little bit more here. Now this is going to be covered, but just in case, I don't want that then we have white at the end visible when we put the parts together. And here there is nothing to paint with brown. Just I'm looking for the I'm going to do the bell of the back of the bell of this. Sorry, I went off camera. But this is not a lot of detail here. To explain is just apply the Doombull Brown on all these parts. I will wait until this dry. We can start, for example. Now the next step is I will take Agrax Earthshade, shake it well. Okay, and we are going to apply Agrax Earthshade. We are going to do a wash as even as possible. So for example here, I'm going to apply a wash on all the parts. Okay. And after this wash, we will need to wait a while that the wash is completely dry before doing the next step. Okay, this will the Agrax Earthshade. I prefer to use Agrax Earthshade in that case because I want really deep shades in the recesses. If you want something that is less, so you want to make the shares less noticeable, you can use what's called the paint Rich Gland Flesh Shade. Okay, the Seraphim Sepia is another option, but it's a little bit too light for my taste. So on the leg, I will do first the bottom, okay, of the leg, and then I will do the top in two faces, because if not I cannot handle the leg. And as you can see, I do go just over all the parts and I do a wash. Okay. This, to be fair, is going to be my only golden stonecutter eternal. But I think I will do the knee protection in a second step. So I take a clamp. I will put it like that. It's better if you put the clamp before painting. I will leave it in a position that the paint, the fresh paint, is not touching any part. Then this one, prepare the clamp to be ready for after. Then I start, I will do it later, because this is more difficult to clamp. So I start from the top. Don't forget here where we have the neck protection, and we are going to just wash, and you will see that when you wash that, all the text, and you can be generous here with the wash, there is a lot of texture in this front armor, so I'm not very scared. And later on we are going to do the cleanup. So okay, I will even go a little bit on top of this here. This is too much here, of course. So you have to remove the pools. So you use this pool to do the leg. You want to avoid pools of paint, because then it's going to be difficult to deal to clean that later on. In that case, we can do all the parts. And we wait until this guy before doing the next step. So you see, this part, these steps are quite straightforward. It's just the preparation before doing the fan work. Why these washes of Citadel, I love them. Still remember when we didn't have these washes, was much harder to do any of this work. I leave it like that. I will keep this miniature in that position. And I need a better clamp than this one. Okay. I just check that I don't have pools of paint. And you can see I'm driving a little bit the paint from this thing. We will need to, once it's assembled, we will need to do some touches, some repairs. But this is normal when you paint. Like that. Okay. Now I will wait until this dries and I will be back in a minute. Okay, this is how it's looking like, and let me go a little bit and zoom in. So this is how it looks like now the armor that the wash is dry. You see that we have all the sheets, and now we start preparing the armor for the glowing on all these runes, and also I will do glowing on this type. I think I will do this type of belt in more in bluish color. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a hawk turquoise or turquoise, and I'm going to paint around the runes. And yeah, I can use the wet palette to do that, to keep, because it's a little bit too dry this paint. So I'm going to use just the wet palette. It's not that I need, so we can I will show you how to do the runes. I will do some of them, and then I can work, for example, the ones. It's going to be easier if I do on camera Disney, for example. So I will apply first the hawk blue. I will limit it to this type of socket in the armor where we have the rune. Okay. And I will do the same on all of them. Here we have a V. So I will work on the knee, and then you can imagine that I will repeat the same on all the runes that we have on the miniature, and then on the bell I will do the same. I will apply the same blue color to be consistent. I want to keep my palette limited. I don't want to put much more colors. I will only add additional color on the green on the wings to match the wings that I do for my army. Here what I'm doing is just see that it's quite thin down. It's almost a little bit more than the glaze, but it's, I keep a little bit transparent. It's not a problem because I want that this blue mainly goes to the slot of these decorations. Okay. I'll do that here. Okay. And now what I'm going to do on the runes is I will use Baharroth Blue. Again, I take some, I put on my wet palette. Not too much, I don't need too much paint. I add some water. Make sure that it's not too thick. And I will try to pick up the runes. So for example, I will start with the V. Sorry if my finger is in front. Okay. Sorry. I will go to this one. Okay, I go with the brush horizontal. Okay. Here I missed a little bit of blue here. So I will do first the one on top. Okay, and finally we'll do this one here. And we're going to follow the same process for all the runes. So this way we'll do the runes, and then on the bell, I will just do the square. And the middle. Square. And the middle. Okay. If it's not well, if you have one little bit on the slot, I take a little bit of the Hawk. Turquoise. Last step, I will use white. Like here on the bell, I will apply a little bit of white. On the corners. And on the runes, okay, something like that. So this is what I'm going to repeat in all the runes. I will do this before doing the gold. So let me see if I can show you better. So this is how I will paint the runes. Okay, and this is how will come the bell. Okay, so I will keep working on that and I will be back once this is done. So this is how it looks like now that the wash have the vine, and we have we have done the highlights also on the we have made this type of runes and symbols. You see we did in all the different parts. Here we have, and we did the bell. So this is here. Here we don't have anything on the other part. So now the next step they will start working. First I will do this bell. Here, these things here, I don't know how this is called, and I will use the same color that I'm using for this thing. I'm wanting to use brown, but I think at the end for this guy make more sense to use the screaming pink. So I will apply exactly the same technique that I applied in the previous video. So to avoid repeat and do explain the same techniques another time, please, if you are interested to know how I do the screaming pink color, how I apply that, I did a video explaining how I do this cape. I will apply the same type of techniques here. So I will just paint that and I will come back once this is done, because really, I will. There is not much new to say on this part, and I will be back once this is done. So now that I did this part here, I'm ready to start doing the highlights on the gold. So to work the gold, I will use again Retributor Armor. Okay, I'm going to use Auric Armor Gold. I will use Lamia Medium to dilute or to thin the Auric Armor Gold, because it's a little bit too thick, the one I have. And I will use a Speed Metal. You cannot read it because it's almost wrapped off. From a scale 75. So I will put this on my palette. I will start working with them. So what I will I will put them in the palette when I need it. I will start first with the Retributor Armor. I will do the chest plate, and the rest is done in the same way. So I will do the lion head as a chest plate. The first thing I will do is I will add brightness, because the problem is when you do the wash, everything is more dull after the wash. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to apply back Retributor Armor to increase the shininess, leaving the recesses without the brightness. Okay? And I'm realizing now this my Retributor Armor start to be a little bit too thick, and I will need to thin it a little bit. But as you can see, I will just do this part first, paint this part, and then do the part. I will paint the armor by sections, because I want to see with all the highlights how it's looking like, and how all the lights are playing, and see if everything makes sense. So as you can see, I just applied a little bit of Retributor Armor. Now we'll take Auric Armor Gold. I will put on the palette, because it's too thick on the cuff. Shake it well to be sure that everything is mixed correctly on the metallics, that the particles are well. Yeah, my Retributor Armor starts to be too thick. Sorry, my Auric Armor Gold. I will put some Lamium Medium. So thin it down. Okay, it's better to have it quite thin, to have more control. And next to this on the palette, I will put the silver from Speed Metal from Scale 75. It's quite, you need to shake it quite well. Okay, here I have. So I will start first with Auric Armor Gold. Okay, and I will start applying on the parts that I want to do some highlight. Sorry, I went off camera. Sorry. A little bit here to make it easier. So I was applying just Auric Armor Gold on the areas that I want to highlight. Okay. I will do also the neck protection. Now I will take I will apply a little bit of Retributor Armor here in this part. Now I will start using the Speed Metal with a little bit of Auric Armor Gold, but mainly Speed Metal. And I will apply it on the part that I want to have some bright, for example here. Here and here. Okay. Then Auric Armor Gold. Okay. So you want to have a little bit of spin metal visible. But at the end of the day, you don't want it to be super noticeable. Okay. I was thinking if I will do the ace of this dragon head with glowing, and at the end I decide I will not do that because I am doing the runes with the glowing. I will do the ace of the helmet with the glowing, so will be too much glowing if I do also the ace, and will do weird to have two dots on the breast and two dots on the mask. Just they will be too close when the overall miniature is painted. So I will decide to keep the armor, the breast without glowing. Just playing with the highlights on the gold. I'm applying speed metal or silver to the went out. I was trying to do it on the rivets. I will also have next to me, we have to be careful now, the wash, Agrax Earthshade. Okay. What I will do is I will apply this next to the rivet. Let's this part dry. Now we are going to do this part here of the armor plate. So there is a comet here. Okay. And what I'm going to do is I will emphasize this with a little bit of Agrax Earthshade next to the comet. Okay. The same here. Okay. I will let it dry first. Here, for example, one thing that I want to show here that I accumulate too much wash. The way to clean up this is I will use Retributor Armor again, and I will start going next to this. Okay, and to make the transition softer, I take a little bit of the wash and I will go a little bit more, and I will go here and mix it a little bit. Okay. In that way, we'll make the transition a little bit softer. Okay. The leg, for example, I will apply a little bit of armor here. Because this part I want to highlight. Okay. I will put now in fast camera, and you can see how I'm working. And how the highlights are coming. So yeah, I will put down in fast camera because indeed the head is done. So the head, the breast is going to do. The only thing we can do here to finalize this in normal speed is on the teeth. We are going to add a little bit of this, then make Auric Armor Gold, something like that. Okay, so I will keep working on the gold and I will be back. I will
put it on fast camera, I mean.
I will keep doing the same on the other parts of the armor, and I will be back once the other parts are done. So I will use the same technique for all the other parts, and I will do also the arms, the weapons. I will do it in a different part of the tutorial. So to finalize this part of the tutorial, I will do the other part. I will show how they look like, and then we are going to do the tail on the brown and all the small details and glue everything together. But now I will do the rest of the parts of camera, and I will be back once the rest of the parts are painted with gold. So at the end, I did all the highlights on the gold and I glued them together, as you can see here. I'm not very concerned about this gap here on the other shoulder pad because it's going to be covered by the shoulder pads, but I wanted to glue them together, all together, to see if the lights that I did make sense and to see if I have to do some additional highlights. For example, I think I will do something here on the rib. So this is, I just want to share you how it's looking like now that I assembled everything together. I also did that because I will need to clean up now a little bit the cape, as I wrap a little bit of the paint, so I will need to do some cleaning up or touches. This is how it's looking like at this moment, and this is the armor. Okay, with the glowing runes that I prefer to do, this from the back. I also wanted to glue to see that it makes no sense to spend a lot of time on the back of the armor as it's completely covered. So I like to paint everything to see how it's looking like, and also to avoid painting areas or go to high detail once it's assembled. Here are the arms, as I said, and I did
one of these things. I will explain now how to do one of these lightning gems. I have the other one here. I will just now explain how to do that. And I also prepare the buckle of the, or this detail that goes on the belt, goes here. Okay, as you can see, I painted. So I will explain how to paint the gem here. So next step, I will, I will do now this detail, and I will be, I will put the camera back to do this last part. And then I will explain how to do the gem on when I'm doing the arms and the weapons.
So now to finalize the work on the armor, I'm going to explain how to paint this buckle that goes on front of the miniature, and I will do the gem in purple. So to do the gem in purple, I will use the next colors. I will use, I will put it like that, Naggaroth Night. I will use Xereus Purple, Genestealer Purple, and Dechala Lilac. Okay, and I put all these colors on my wet palette to be able to blend them together. So I will start applying Naggaroth Night. Let's see. I'm gonna put this in the camera if I want to zoom in. So I will start applying Naggaroth Night on all the gem. Okay. And this is right like a big gem, and I will paint this more like a gem than glowing or any other thing. So, you see, I applied Naggaroth Night. Now I will use the next in the scale, this Xereus Purple, and I will apply, I will do, and you see that the Naggaroth Night is still not dry, but it's not a problem. So, because I want, this will help me in softening the transition. Okay, so I will apply all except the top. Okay. Now the next step, I will apply the next in the scale, Genestealer Purple. This is much clearer, and you see that I'm doing. Okay. And I will end up using the Dechala Lilac, that is the age paint from Age Workshop. Doing something like that. And now with the same Dechala Lilac, I will do a spot on the top. Okay. This gem is so big that you can do a couple of spots. Okay. And you can go even, and we use no white, you can use any white you want. And I will add white on the biggest spot. Okay. Now I will go back. That I, while I was doing that, the previous colors have dry. I will take again Genestealer Purple, and I will apply a little bit. And all the paints have been thinned down with, are thinned with water. Now I use again Xereus Purple. Okay, and this is how I will do the gem. So this is how the gem is looking like. Okay. You can even make, in that case that is so big, can even do second bright point at the bottom. So this is how it's looking like. So let me just see if I can zoom in a little bit more. No. It's losing focus, sorry. So this is how the gem will look like, and now we can glue that on the miniature. And I will show you now this glue it on the miniature and just show you how the miniature is looking like with everything assembled, and close up this part of the painting tutorial. So I just glued the gem, as you can see here, on the bell. The last thing that I will do is I will use gloss varnish, and we are going to make this gloss. So we want to put a little bit of gloss varnish on this gem. I like to do this always on all the gems. Just take some varnish, we go over, okay, and we light until this line. And this will finalize this part of the tutorial. So we're explaining how to do the armor. Okay, and we are ready now to start painting. I will do maybe the head. We are going to be ready to do the head. So this is finalizing this part, and in the next part I will do the head and the shoulder pads. Now I will do first the weapons and the arms to finish the arms, and then I will do the head and the shoulder pads. And finally, I will do the wings. And after that, I will do just final touches and cleaning up of the miniature. So this is how it's looking like. I hope you like it. I hope you're finding this series of tutorial interesting and you like how the job is coming on. So yeah, that's all for now. Please comment, like if you like it. Subscribe if you're not subscribed. And if you want to see more tutorials, if you want to see more about my paint job, and you want to support this channel, I'd let you know that they have a Patreon account where you can support me, and depending on the support I will be able to do more tutorials and more of the about new products. So yeah, the money that I can spend on the hobby, so the money that I get from the channel will be dedicated fully to the channel, put back to the channel in order to do product reviews, in order to do tutorials, in order to have all the stuff needed to do tutorials. And if I reach some of the goals, I will be able to do tailored tutorials. So you can ask what you want, and then I will purchase the miniature and I will do the tutorial. But this is depending on the goals and how I'm reaching the goals. So far, I appreciate a lot the people that is now supporting me in the channel. And that's all for now. Please, as I said before, comment, like, subscribe if you haven't subscribed. Thanks a lot for watching, and see you again later. Bye.